my dear learners, for this course on design of machinery elements 1. In our previous lecture, I have introduced you people to the concept of design for impact strength, and I have derived expressions for axial impact stress and bending impact stress. In today's lecture, we will be discussing problems on axial impact stresses. Let us quickly move on and discuss our problem number 1. Problem number 1 of our discussion on design for impact stress, impact strength, states that a steel rod of 1.5 meter long, it has to resist longitudinally an impact of 2.5 kN falling under gravity at a velocity of 0.99 meters per second. Maximum computed stress is limited to 150 megapascals. Determine diameter of the rod required, impact factor, instantaneous deformation and instantaneous load. As I explained in our previous lecture itself, if I want to determine any instantaneous quantities, I should know impact factor. Multiply impact factor to the static quantities to get the instantaneous quantities. And one more very important thing to be noted down is that the expression for static deflection is FL by AE for axial impact, whereas expression for static deflection should be taken from table 1.4, page number 15 of our design data handbook for bending impact analysis. For axial impact analysis, the value of static deflection is FL by AE, whereas for bending impact analysis, the value of static deflection should be taken from table 1.4 of our design data handbook written by K. Madhavan and Balveer Reddy. We'll be referring 4th edition. Let us note the data first to solve this problem. Coming for the data given, there is a steel rod of 1.5 meters long. So length is known. It is 1500 millimeters. It has to resist longitudinally an impact of 2.5 kN. So load is known. It is 2.5 kN. Falling under gravity at a velocity is given 0.99 meters per second. And maximum computed stress, that is instantaneous stress or impact axial stress, maximum is 150 megapascals. Determine diameter of the rod required, impact factor, instantaneous deformation, that is y dash, instantaneous load, w dash. Since we know the value of impact stress, using this expression we can find one unknown quantity, but any instantaneous quantities if you use, you should know the impact factor first. So to find the impact factor, we already know that impact factor is given by, so we are solving problem number 1. Impact factor is given by 1 plus root of 1 plus 2h by static deflection or deformation. So for static deformation, it is FL by AE for axial impact conditions. So this impact factor equation is available in our design data handbook from equation 2.26a, 2.26b, 2.26c, etc. Equations of 2.26 contains this impact factor equation. If you find any difficulty to remember this equation, you can refer design data handbook, where h is height of falling. So height of falling is also not given, but in our previous class I discussed about impact energy. While defining the impact energy, I stated that if we know load and we know velocity, we can find from what height it is falling by using equations of Newton's law of motion. So using equations of Newton's law of motion, we can find h as v square by 2g. So v is 0.99 square divided by 2 into 9.81. So you get the value of h as 0.99 square divided by 2 into 9.81 millimeters, the value as 49.95 millimeters. I know the value of h. Now the value of y is given by FL by AE. Here again we don't know the value of area because we don't know the diameter. So if I solve this in terms of area, because diameter is unknown to me, so coming for Young's modulus, which is also unknown, for steel rod we can assume for steel E is equal to 210 GPa. Whenever Young's modulus is missing for the material given from the design pattern book, you take this Young's modulus. Here we can assume the Young's modulus as 210 GPa. So usually the Young's modulus for steel of various combinations varies from 200 GPa to 210 GPa. So now if I substitute and solve, I will get Y is equal to, load is 2.5 into 10 to the power of 3, length is 1500, divided by area is unknown, and Young's modulus is 210 GPa, so therefore it is 210 into 10 to the power of 3 MPa. So static deflection will be 2.5 exponential 3 into 1500 divided by 210 exponential 3. So static deflection is 17.857 by A, where area should be substituted in terms of millimeter square. This is because of the reason L is in mm and Young's modulus is also in Newton per millimeter square. So therefore the value of impact factor will be 1 plus root of 1 plus 2 into 49.95 into A divided by 17.857. So therefore I will get the impact factor in terms of area as 2 into 49.95 divided by 17.857, 1 plus root of 1 plus 5.594 times the area. So in terms of area, we have calculated the impact factor. Now we know the value of instantaneous maximum stress, so therefore instantaneous quantities is equal to static quantities into impact factor, is the general expression we know. So static direct stress is force by area, so force is known, 2.5 kN, impact factor is also in terms of area. Since area is the only unknown, I can find the area now. So 150 megapascals is given. So static direct stress is force by area, which is 2.5 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by area into impact factor is 1 plus root of 1 plus 5.594 times the area. So if I solve this equation, I will get the value of area as 150 is equal to 2.5 exponential 3 by alpha x into 1 plus root of 1 plus 5.594 alpha. So the value of area is 15.87.22 millimeter square. So therefore I can find the diameter is, area is pi d square by 4, so therefore pi d square by 4 is equal to 15.87.22. So therefore, the diameter of the rod required will be answering to 4 divided by pi square root of answer will be 44.95. So diameter of the rod required is 44.95 millimeters. So I have determined the diameter. Now impact factor can directly solve. We know impact factor in terms of area. So therefore impact factor will be 1 plus root of 1 plus 5.594 into area is 1587.22. So impact factor is 95.23. So next we want to determine instantaneous deformation. Third one, instantaneous deformation y dash is equal to static deformation into impact factor. So therefore y dash is equal to static deformation is also in terms of area. So therefore, static deformation will be 17.857 divided by area is 1587.22. Hence, the impact factor is 95.23. So, I will get the instantaneous deformation as answer multiplied by 17.857. Divided by area 1587.22 is 1.0714 millimeters. If you want to determine the static deformation, I can substitute area here and get the static deformation also. Coming for instantaneous load, W dash is equal to W into impact factor. So therefore W dash is equal to 2.5 × 10³ into 95.23. So W dash will be 2.5 × 10³ into 95.23. It reaches 238 kN. So this is the solution for problem number 1. Let me pause this video for a while so that you people can note it down. So later we will address problem number 2. Moving for problem number 2. Problem number 2 states that an unknown weight falls through 20 mm onto a collar rigidly attached to the lower end of a vertical bar 2 meter long and 500 square millimeter section with the maximum instantaneous extension is 2 millimeters. What is the corresponding stress and the value of the unknown weight? Let us solve this problem. Solution for problem number 2. If I note on the data given, there is an unknown weight falling through 20 mm onto a collar rigidly attached to the lower end of a vertical bar. So if you clearly observe the problem, it is axial and impact. The problem is similar to the derivation of axial impact stress. So we have an unknown load falling from a height of 20 millimeters onto a collar rigidly attached to the lower end of a vertical bar of 2 meters long. So length is 2000 millimeters and the cross sectional area is 500 mm square. If the maximum instantaneous extension, that is y dash, is 2 millimeters, what is the corresponding stress sigma dash? and the value of unknown weight W. Take the value of E as 210^3 megapascals. Now, if you clearly observe the problem, we have an bar to which we have a collar attached. So there is a load falling whose magnitude is unknown, but height of falling is known, and this is causing a maximum extension of 2 millimeters. So there is an extension of 2 mm. And the length of the bar is also known to us. So this is the problem given. Now, so we know length, we know instantaneous extension, we know Young's modulus. So by using the definition of Young's modulus itself, we can find the impact stress, that is impact stress is equal to Young's modulus into impact strain. So impact stress is equal to Young's modulus is 210^3 megapascals into strain is change in length by original length. So instantaneous change in length is known, 2 mm, original length is also known, 2000 mm. So therefore, I will get the instantaneous stress, which is 200^3 into 2 by 2000. I will get the value as 200 megapascals. So one quantity we have calculated. Now, to find the value of W, let us go for the impact factor. We know the value of sigma dash. So using sigma dash, I can find the value of W. Instantaneous stress is equal to static axial stress into impact factor. Now, substitute the values, let us see what is the unknown. So we know the instantaneous stress is 200, static direct stress is force by area, force is unknown, W divided by area is 500 mm square into impact factor is given by the formula 1 plus root of 1 plus 2h by static deformation. Now, the value of static deformation is what I should calculate. The value of static deformation is FL by AE for axial loading conditions, whereas for bending conditions, we should use table 1.4 of page number 15 of our design diagram book. For various loading conditions of various beams, we have various expressions for static deflection. Whereas for axial deformation, the static axial deformation is given by FL by AE. So we know that static deformation is given by FL by AE. So substitute and simplify, I will get the value of load. So 200 is equal to W by 500 into 1 plus root of 1 plus height of falling is 20 mm into 2 divided by load is unknown, length is 2000 into area into Young's modulus, area is 500 into Young's modulus is 210^3, which is nothing but 2×10^5. So if I simplify further, I will get the value as 200 into 500, which is 110^3, which is nothing but 10^5, is equal to W into 1 plus root of 1 plus 20 into 2 into 500 into 2 exponential 5 divided by 2000. You get the value as 2 into 10 to the power of 6 by W. So if I solve this equation, you get the value of load as 4545.45 newtons is the load. So this is the solution for problem number 2, where in which he has asked us to determine the instantaneous maximum stress and unknown weight value, that is W. So this completes our discussion on axial impact loading conditions. From next lecture, we will be heading to discuss bending impact loading conditions. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.